Hi there, welcome to Teachers Tech. My name is Jamie and it's great to have you here. Today I want to show you how to use the function XLOOKUP in Microsoft Excel. So you can use XLOOKUP to replace the functions VLOOKUP or HLOOKUP in Microsoft Excel. So I'm going to go through five different examples here today, kind of showing you it in action. And I'm going to put a link to the spreadsheet also so you can download it and follow along with me. So let's get started on how to use the XLOOKUP function in Microsoft Excel. Before we get started here today, I just want to point out that the XLOOKUP function is not available in Excel 2016 or 2019, but you could come across it if it's somebody in a newer version did create an XLOOKUP function and then you were opening that one. So why would you even use the XLOOKUP function in Microsoft Excel? Well, you can use it to find things, whether it be in a table or range by row. So let me give you a simple example of using XLOOKUP. You could use VLOOKUP for this also, but this is one of the ways you could replace VLOOKUP. Now, if I wanted to search in this column for a country and return a dial code, so look at this. So if I just was going to type something like the United States in here, you can see how it returned the plus one. And if I look at this, United States plus one. So it went down this column here, searching by row for the United States, what I typed up in here, and it returned this. So let's start how to use the XLOOKUP function to do this. So if you're following along with the worksheets that I gave you, you can see that the formula using the XLOOKUP is already in it. So if you're following along now, you can go ahead and just hit delete and then build it as I go along. So let's start with building this first simple one. And to do this, we're actually going to use the insert function. So it's just on this first one that I'm going to be using the insert function, but I'm going to just choose it. And you can see we do a search for it. So you don't even have to type the whole thing. And you'll find the function right here. So I'm going to go and open up the function arguments now, and this is where we can start. So what do we want to have happen? Well, I've selected F2 where I'm putting this formula in. So this is where it's going to return the results of what I build here. What's the first thing I need to look up? So I'm going to type in a name of a country here, and I want it to return the code. So we need to look up, and what you can see it's flashing in this one. I could select this, or I can just click here, and it goes to E2. So it needs to look up what's in E2. And then I'm going to move down to the next argument, and it's going to look up the array. So what's the array? So it's going to be from China to Mexico that I need to select that range. So I'm just going to click on China, hold down and drag and select from A2 to A11. So what is going to be the return array? So I need to click in the next one and the return array is going to be this right here. So I'm just going to go ahead and select this. Now at this point I can hit OK. And notice that since I had the United States selected, it returns plus one. And now if I was going to pick a new one, so I'll type Mexico. And so it went down this range that I told it to, and it went found Mexico, and it returned this prefix here, the plus 52. So that's the first example of how to use XLOOKUP in a formula, and a very simple one. So let's move forward and how we can find multiple items using XLOOKUP. In this next example of XLOOKUP, I'm going to show you how it can return multiple items. So in this example, this is what we're going to build. When we put an employee ID number in, so if I put 45464 in here like this and hit enter, it returns an employee name and department in it. So return multiple items. And let's say if all of a sudden I put in a number that's not there, it can actually return not found. And I'm going to show you how you can actually add this to your XLOOKUP function. So again, this is where the XLOOKUP function is going to live. And I'm going to hit delete. And we're on the second tab right now where it says multiple items. So let's start building this. So this time I'm just going to start in B2 and I'm going to just use the equal sign here and I'm going to start typing XLOOKUP. And I'm going to go ahead and select it because it was already found. And I'm just going to type out the formula and select everything that I need. So what is the place where it's going to look up? So I showed you that the employee ID here is going to be what's going to be what it's looking for. So I need to say, click on this spot. So it's going to look up A2. And what is it going to do next? So if I put a comma, and then it's going to have our lookup array. So it's going to look up our employee ID, just like that. So then what we need to do is add a comma and then our return array. And what I can do for the return array is select both columns. So this entire range is going to be from B5 up here to C14 down here. So I can go ahead and just finish this like this and hit enter. Now notice it says NA because this number is not noticed. So if I was going to type in 2345, it can find this because I haven't added that other argument of not found. So how do you do that? Well, if I go back to where the formula was, and let's say I want to add a little bit extra to this, all I have to do is add another comma, and then you can see it says if not found. So what do I want it to do? I can just type not found, but you do need to add your quotation marks first, and then you can go ahead and end your quotation marks and then hit return. So now if I go ahead and enter a random number, you can see it says not found because it looked through all these employee IDs, didn't find it. And then we said if it didn't find it, that it can put back not found. So that's another example how you can find multiple items using the XLOOKUP. So in this next XLOOKUP example, I want to show you how you can type a number in here. So let's go ahead and just put a random number in here, and it's going to return a tax rate. So notice it doesn't have to be an exact one. It just still found the tax rate too for it. And so it searched down this column right here and returned the matching one. And I just want to point out it went from right to left. If you ever used VLOOKUP before, you know you can only go from left to right when you're doing that type of formula. So let me show you how you can build this one using XLOOKUP. So we're on the third tab now, find matching, and I'm going to go ahead and delete the formula. So I'll just click into this cell, hit delete, and we'll start again. So to start with, I'm going to use the equal sign, and what's going to be the formula? Well, it's the XLOOKUP. So there it is right there. So the first thing that we need to put is the lookup value, and it's going to be whatever we put in here. So this is the lookup value, and we're going to put a comma. So what is it going to look up? Well, it's going to look up this right through here. So it's going to look up the amounts right through here. And then I'm going to put a next comma, and it's going to have a return rate. So this is where it's going to return the tax rate. So I need to select the tax rate like this. So what I need to do next is continue. I'm not done yet. I need to add a comma. So then it's if not found. What I need to do is put a zero in here. So if nothing is found, then it needs to go to the match mode. So now here are my options for the match mode. Is it going to be what numbers? You can see from 0 to -1 to 1 to 2. So we're going to put a 1 in here, which means the function will look for the exact match. So just like that. But what happens if it doesn't find the exact match? Then we have some more options. We're going to choose this time to go with another 1. So search first to last. So just put another 1 just like that. And now we can go ahead and close this and let's test it out. So let's pick a number, and I'll pick a number where it'll be between this here. So I'll pick 195,000. So 195,000, hit return, 33%. So it searched, it didn't find the 195,000. So it went through all these different options here, didn't find the exact match, but then it found the next larger. So that's what we told it to do as we created this formula using the XLOOKUP. So in this next example, you can see if we look at the formula, there's going to be two XLOOKUP functions. This one is nested inside of this one. So what is this going to do? So if I go ahead and type in quarter, let's say 3, it can return the information. So it's doing a vertical lookup and it's also doing a horizontal lookup. So you can use XLOOKUP in this situation to replace HLOOKUP. All right, let's get started on how to create this formula. So I just want to point out the nested XLOOKUP formula is in each of these three spots because I do copy it over and I am going to be using the dollar sign just to be able to hold the columns in place when I copy. I'm going to go ahead and delete these three right here and we can start from scratch. So what do we need to start with? We'll start with the equal sign and start our finding our XLOOKUP. Just like so. So what's the first thing that we're going to look up? We're going to look up gross profit. So it's just going to be picking gross profit. I don't have to put the dollar sign of with this because as it copies over, I do want it to move over to the right. So I'm going to put my comma. What is it going to look up? It's going to look up this column right through here. So this vertical column, I do need to hold this into this column. So I'm going to put the dollar sign here. So just go ahead and add right in front of each one like so and add a comma. This is where we can add our nested XLOOKUP. So if I start typing our XLOOKUP just like so, and now what are we looking up this time? Well, we're going to look up C3. So what is C3? It's going to be whatever I type in right here. Now I have to hold this in spot, so I need to put the dollar sign in front of this C3. So when I copy it over, it stays looking up C3 for the quarter. Now I can go back, I put my comma. What is it looking up for quarter? Well, you can see across the horizontal right through here. So I'm going to actually select all through here just like this. So it's going to be looking up this part right here. So I do need to put my dollar signs in front of the both C's here. So just go ahead and put in front of the G also. And what does it need to return? Well, it needs to return. It needs to look through all of this just like that. So it's going to go from C6 to G17. And I do need to make these with the dollar sign, the absolute. So I'm going to go ahead and put them in again, just like this. So I can close my brackets. We're going to need two at the end here because one closes this first one here and then another one to make sure I close both arguments. So I'm going to hit enter to end it and let's copy this over. So I put this in one spot. And now if I go ahead and just drag it over, grab that little green little square and drag it over, and I'm just going to change the formatting on this back to percent, just like that. And now we can try using something else. So let's try total. And you can see what it went through. It found total over here and returned the different things I told it to look for. It found the gross profit. So if I look over here, the 135,400, the net profit over here, 104,000, and it returned the profit. So it said 30%, but that's because my decimals were only to one place there. So now I can change it so it all matches. So that's how we looked up using XLOOKUP. We looked up a vertical and horizontal way. So you can replace your HLOOKUP using this with the nested XLOOKUP function. So in this next and final example, we're going to be summing something up using XLOOKUP. We're actually going to be using two nested XLOOKUP. And how this works is whatever I put in for the start, it will add up the range between the two, or so including the two. So if I was going to type in grape here, so if I type grape and then I was going to type cherry here, what it's going to do is it's going to add up to 6142, 1530, 1312, and 990, and it's going to give me a total for that. So we're going to be using, as I said, two nested XLOOKUP and the sum function. So let's get started with this. So I'm going to go ahead and just delete this, you can see there is the formula that we have, and we're going to rebuild it from scratch again. We'll start with our equal sign, and I'm going to put the sum function in first. So what is it I need to sum? Well, this is where I'm going to put my first nested X lookup. I'm going to choose X lookup here. And what is going to be the first thing I look up? Well, it's going to be the B3. So that's going to be the start of this. And I need to put my comma. Where is it going to look up? Well, it's going to look up between B6 and 10. So it's going to look up right here. So at this point, I can go ahead and just do another comma like this. And what's going to be my return? Well, it's going to be the totals here. So I'm going to just go ahead and I can end this first one with a bracket. I don't need to add dollar signs or anything. I'm not copying this over. And at this point, I'm going to put my colon in and then add another X lookup here. So I'm going to go use the X lookup up here. And then so I can go and keep going to the next one. So what is the next thing I'm going to look up? Well, it's the end. So it's going to be C3, and I'm going to use my comma and select this again, and I'm going to use the comma again. And what is it I'm going to select? Well, it's going to be the total over here. And at this point, I can close it with the two brackets, just like that. So it's going to sum up. Now the sum's on the outside here, so it's going to look up this, X look up this, X look up this, and then sum up. So I'm going to hit return. Let's test this out. If we go say apple, and we are just say grape, like so, hit return, $90.66, and you can see that's what the total of those two, if it was extended to everything here, and we put cherry, it's the whole total of everything there. So that's how you would use the sum function with two nested X lookup functions. So go ahead and play with the different ones that I created here for you here today. Hope you like this explanation of X lookup. And if you're able to use it, if you have the correct version of this, let me know what's working, what's not working for you in the comments below. What else you want to learn about Excel? Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next week with more tech tips and tutorials.